Why do spiral galaxies have arms? Is it to hug us? Hey, Star Citizens, Trace here for DNews. When you think of the Milky Way, you probably picture that familiar spiral shape we've all come to know and love. That spiral structure is very common for galaxies. Over 3/4 of the ones we've observed are in this pinwheel shape. And our own galaxy is actually in a subgroup called barred spiral galaxies. But how exactly spiral galaxies get their shape is still up for debate. Most galaxies spin around a central point, usually a supermassive black hole. It's tempting to think that those spiral arms are practically solid structures with the same stars all sticking together as they revolve around the center of the galaxy. If that were true, that would mean that the stars on the tips of the arms would have to move faster than the stars near the center to keep up. This doesn't jive well with the laws of physics. In reality, objects move faster when they're closer to the point they're orbiting around, otherwise they'd lose the battle with gravity and fall in. This is Kepler's third law, and it's why Earth's orbit takes a year while Mercury's is just 88 days. This means, though, that if the arms were made up of the same stars, then as the galaxy rotates, the arms would get stretched out and wound up like they were in a giant cosmic taffy machine. Our Sun takes around 250 million years to do a lap of the galaxy, which sounds like a long time, but on an astronomical timescale, it's actually pretty quick. At those speeds, spiral galaxies should wind their arms into oblivion before any appreciable length of time, and we shouldn't be observing as many of these galaxies as we do. Astronomers call this the wind-up problem, and they've come up with two explanations for the arms. One is that the arms aren't material, but actually the product of a density wave. As stars travel around the galaxy, they'll come to areas where they'll all bunch up for a while, and areas where they're more spread out. This means that though the stars are moving inside of the arms themselves look pretty stationary. You can think of this like a traffic jam. From afar, the jam appears to stay in one place on the highway, but the cars that make up the jam are actually flowing through it. What would cause these density waves in the first place is still hotly debated. Astronomers have found that spiral arms could be caused by other nearby galaxies, or driven by the large bar shape at the center of some galaxies, but these bars and companion galaxies are not universal, so explaining galaxies that have neither with the density wave model is tricky. The other popular explanation is stochastic self-propagating star formation, but its friends call it SSPSF. The basic idea behind it is star formation in a galaxy causes a shock wave that kicks off more star formation. The rotation of the galaxy stretches the bright new stars into familiar spiral arms, and they burn out and die as the chain reaction propagates and the arms move on. It's possible SSPSF and the density wave model actually work together, and stars are formed in the denser areas, making the arms look brighter with their hot new stars. So those are the most accepted explanations of spiral formation, but some of the finer points, like figuring out if these spirals are long-lived or transient features, can only be answered after hundreds of millions of years of observation. So if you're looking for a career with job security, might I suggest astronomy? For a long time, we thought that we were the only galaxy. And then we found Andromeda. If you want to know more about our galactic neighbor, you should check out Julia's video on it right here.
Scientists recently made a really cool discovery using the Hubble Space Telescope. They discovered that Andromeda is surrounded by a giant ball of gas, and I mean giant. It nearly reaches halfway to the Milky Way. That's more than a million light years. Whoa. It's so big that if you could see it with the naked eye, its diameter would be 100 times the size of the moon.
Space is a big topic, and there are lots of questions to explore. Let us know down in the comments if you have a space question you want us to look into. Make sure you subscribe so you can get the answer to that question. And thanks for watching DNews.